tractor is pretty old. The filter is actually up on top. Like, oh, all of them are on top. But it's actually located here under this big pan thing. That's the way this engine's designed. So, here it is. Looks pretty good. I need to clean that off a little bit. But this one's a little bit harder to take out than most of the new ones. You have to actually take out a bolt, and then it'll come off. But make sure you keep that clean out, because that's important to keeping your engine in good working condition. And everything. If you get dust in there, that's not good. And if you also, if you don't use your tractor too much, then make sure you disconnect your battery. Like, if you're gonna leave it sit for a long time, most of the time it's good. And the next thing, you have to check your trans oil, which right here is where it actually fills in on this tractor, fills up. So we're gonna go run to the back. Check the level. I don't know if this thing's gonna focus on that. But I can see it, and it's still good. Right where it should be. So, that's good. So, what we're gonna do next is start it up and let it warm up a little bit. So, here we go. After this, just give me a second. Oh, and one more thing I forgot to mention. This is how many hours are on this. 1,657.9. It's almost 558. Or 658. Here soon. Maybe even today, we'll have to check. But, anyways, we can get back to doing what I was doing, so give me a second. Okay, so, I'm just gonna jump on here. It's hard to tell from the video, but this tractor's pretty big. I think it is, anyways. So, I'm just loosen the brake here. Just about to do it later. So, what you do first with mine, you give it just a little bit of throttle. It's not a lot. You barely have to move it with this. And right here's the choke. You pull that out. This thing has a built-in electric fuel pump to it. So all you have to do is turn the key. And I don't know if this thing's picking it up or not. But you can hear it's on. So it should fire right up. So here we go. Next, you lift the deck up. Start mowing, all you have to do is let it warm up for a little bit. So, just let it warm up. So, just let it warm up here. So, give me a couple minutes and we'll show you how to. few updates while this thing's warming up. I haven't made any videos for a while, and I'm sorry for that, but I need more batteries for my actual good camera, for my camera. The thing I'm recording with now is, I know, a heck of a lot better quality. I can just tell by looking at it. But I like my little camcorder battery, so I can actually put it on a tripod. I can't with this. So, but it definitely is a lot better quality, and I can zoom in a lot better. Somewhat. So, anyways. It's gonna... KM90R is doing pretty good in there. So it's the VG55. So, yeah, I'm gonna be going to work on Friday again to mow that place. And, I haven't been able to actually mow the tractor for a while, because the tractor has actually been kind of broken, I guess you can say. What was wrong with it is, every time you try to start it, something was like making a knocking noise. It wasn't the engine, but what it was something with the clutch. So that was, and then it was getting fixed, and now it's fine again. So now the place is like a hayfield almost. It's pretty bad. So that's gonna be a lot of fun. Not really, but I'll get it done. I've been going out there the past 2 weeks, but I haven't actually mowed anything with the tractor that had been broken. I've just been doing a little bit when I came with the push mower. So, yeah, not the best. But, anyways, gonna let this warm up for a few more minutes. So, stay tuned. Alright, so it's been a couple of minutes. So we're just gonna get back on. And we're just gonna go over there. So we're not gonna go too far. Gotta take our good old time to get over there. Hopefully now this thing that I'm using picks up the sound a lot better. Repeat the O.